you asked for. Oh, stop it. You're gonna do amazing. You always do amazing. You always get the jitters before every speech, and then once you get up there, you just absolutely kill it every single time. Alright, so I know you couldn't decide between which ties, so I figured I'd bring both, and we'll just see which one works better. So I really like this one, but I don't know if on camera, like, the texture is gonna show up, you know? Like, from far away, it looks a little bit plain. Let's see. It looks nice with the suit, but I'm thinking that for the camera, like, this one just has a little bit more of a pop to it. So I think this is the one that... Yeah, that's it. That's definitely... That's the winner. That looks really good on you. Straighten that a little bit. There we go. Okay, stop it. You are gonna be amazing. I mean, you're by far, hands down, the most intelligent person in that room. Let's just be real. You know more on this topic than everyone else on that panel combined, so you do not have a thing to worry about. I know you get, like, a little anxious before it starts, that's normal, but then every time you get up there, just, like, something takes over you, and no one would ever know that you were nervous before you went on. Okay, so I got everything. Here, let me give you these first, because I know you said you needed a little antacid. I'm not sure if these ones are your favorite or not. These are the assorted berry flavor. It'll do, you know, one in a pinch. So there's that. And then I just wanted to hear me out. I just wanted to just do a little bit of this on your skin. It's not makeup. So, it's just a toner. It's not makeup. It's just a toner. It just shrinks your pores down. And, it just sounds pore tightener. But it really does tighten your pores. You'll feel them just like shrink up. So let me just put a little bit of this on you. You just relax. Get in the zone. Clear your head. Clear your head. Okay. Just put a tiny bit of this on here. You really only need a very small amount. I'm just gonna apply this to your face. Why don't you just close your eyes? It's very subtle, but it does shrink the pores. So just wipe that on your forehead, down your nose, get your cheeks there we go. Oh my god, your pores look out of this world. People are gonna be like, have you seen this man's pores? Okay, and now, just, no, it's not gonna look girly. It's just kinda makes your skin glow, just like brings like life into your skin. Again, it's not makeup, it's just a little glow serum. Okay, again, just a little bit goes a very long way. So, just rub this in my hands. Okay, just, there we are. It's gonna dab that and it just kind of absorbs really quickly. It's not gonna feel like sticky or anything like that. You won't even know it's there. It just, you know, gives your skin a little life, a little glow. You know, in the winter months, we get like a little dried out from all the, you know, running the heaters and coldness. It just kind of like sucks the moisture out of the skin, and that just, you know, brings it back, plumps things up. All right. You know, when you look good, it just helps to boost confidence. It's true. It's true. Trust me on this. This is my area. And allow me to demonstrate my skill set. You know, we all just have to stay in our lane. We all have something to contribute. Not all of us are as brilliant as you, but I do know a thing or two about making someone look their absolute best. And that's why you can never part with me. Stuck with me for life. No, I'm not gonna brush your teeth. Yes, this is a toothbrush, but I'm gonna be using it to actually comb your eyebrows and your beard. I find it works better than like a beard comber or an eyelash comber. So it's brand new, very sanitary, of course, at all times. Cleanliness is close to godliness, as I say. So, just thought we could groom those eyebrows. You have really nice eyebrows, by the way. That is such a gift. And you just have so many gifts. No, honestly, it is a gift. Like, eyebrows really, like, make or break a person. Okay, so let's just comb these bad boys. What do you say? Do not underestimate the power of eyebrows. I'm just gonna not do anything crazy. Just combing them up, and then I go to the side. Just gives a little bit of lift. So what are you gonna eat for your celebratory meal after this is over? I'm just gonna comb your mustache and beard a little bit. Now you have to have a celebratory meal picked out. It's always good to have something to look forward to when you're about to do something that you don't want to do. Oh, that does sound good. Can I join you? Indulgent, but you know, this cause for celebration, so I think we should do it. I heard that they have this new dessert there, and it's like a birthday cake cheesecake. So it has birthday cake and cheesecake mixed together. I've heard it's out of this world. I think we should. I think we have no choice, actually. It would be insulting to them not to get it. Alright, see, your beard, eyebrows, impeccable. Just nothing short of impeccable. I think, I don't mean to insult you, but those nails, they need a little bit of a file. People notice your hands, trust me. They do. No, they do. I'm not gonna do anything crazy. I'm just gonna like smooth out those edges a little bit. You know I love you, and you know I'm always honest. And God forbid the camera zooms in on those hands. Looks like you were raised in a barn. That's all I'm saying. Alright, so give me your hand. Just gentle, gentle filing here. You don't like cheesecake? Alright, I'm sort of rethinking what I said about you being the smartest, most brilliant person I've ever known. Who doesn't like cheesecake? That's just weird. Alright, well, what do you like then? What's your favorite dessert? Are you kidding me? Well, nobody's perfect. Do you like red vines too? Oh my god. You're the worst. You may be brilliant in some areas, but you have some very questionable taste in foods. Alright. Give me a thumb. Do you wanna practice some of like the key points while we're anything, just some of like the statistics and facts and figures. It's in the vault. Good. Alright. Looking good, looking good. Much better. Much, much better. What else do I have in my little Mary Poppins bag? We were at lunch the other day in the sunlight. Like, I noticed that you have just a few little rogue hairs that need to be plucked. Why would I point that out in the middle of lunch? Timing is everything. As you know, there is a time and a place for everything. And while a man is eating his lunch, you do not tell him that he has stray eyebrow hairs that need to be plucked. Okay, let me just, it's honestly, it's like four. Five tops. Maybe ten. Alright, lean in closer, my little Sasquatch. I kid, you know I love you. Oh my god, don't be such a baby. Do you have any idea how many of these, like, hold still. Okay, one, two, three. I forgot how many I said there were. There we go. And we're done. We're done. Here. There we go. All better. All better. There you are. There you are. Have those tums kicked in yet? Just want to. I noticed last time you were on television that there was just a couple of these like wild hairs that were a little astray. I know you're growing your hair out. I just wanted to like smooth a couple of those hairs down. There was just a few that looked texturizing paste, and again, a little of this goes an extremely long way. You can end up looking very greasy, but if you just use like that much, then just smooth things out. Just get this in my fingers. Just want to pat it down. There we go. Okay. Really. Hold on, I'm gonna wipe my hands off. Are you talking shit about my outfit? Damn, shots fired. Well, I will admit this is not my finest performance, but in my defense, I was rushing. these things for you, so I didn't have the time to adequately get ready myself. That is how selfless of a person I am. Off, and then there was a few more things. You're almost done. See, I'm distracting you. The art of distraction. It's kind of a cool sound, huh? Almost like a musical instrument. Did I ever tell you that I'm really good at playing the kazoo? World renowned. Televisions with Scentavision. Wouldn't that be amazing? Like, you know, like if you've been on that ride at California Adventure, now I think they changed it, but there used to be a part where you were flying. It was called, what is that called? I believe it's called Soaring. And there was this part where you're flying over orange groves and they spray like this mist into the air of orange blossoms. Do fly over elephants, I believe. And a whale. No, not in the desert, obviously. It's a different part. All right, enough. Enough out of you. All right, I'm gonna spray this on you. Oh. So incredible. Love that. Such a good sound. It's like a nice, clean, crisp. It's intense, but it will die down soon. So you go out there and you kill it as per usual, and I will be here rooting you on from the sidelines. And then when you're done, we are gonna go have the best meal of your entire life. I don't know if in good conscience I can look up where to get that dessert. I'm sorry. Like some things that, like that Meatloaf song, I would do anything for love, but I won't do that. So everyone has their limits. But you go out there, you kill it, and we'll get an amazing dessert. It won't be that dessert, but it will be a dessert. All right. You look amazing.